你们好, 我是一鸣老师, welcome back. I found a very fun video clip to teach you this expression. Damn it. I don't think it's a bad word or a dirty word, so please don't be harsh to me. It's just an expression when things don't go in your way and you use it to express your unhappiness or anger with the things just happened. So today let's see how to say this in Chinese, and I'm going to teach you with a video clip. It's different between man and woman. The good thing is we can learn both of them in the video I'm going to show you. Here is the context. Yes, he got blackmailed because he didn't have the proof that he didn't hit the man. But let's see what happened the next day. Yes, the same thing happened again. So he said, let's hear it again. Did you hear it? He said, sorry, since this is the way that men say damn it, so it's kind of rude and I'm not going to read it. But you know pinyin and I'm sure you know how to read it. But let's hear one more time how he said it. I know it doesn't sound very clear, but that is what happens in real life. In real life, people don't pronounce the words like the dictionary. One more time. You got it? Okay, let's watch a little more. When the driver got out of the car, the blackmailer found that he got the same man. So, there's no way he can blackmail the same person with the same way twice. He said, you heard it? The same thing. Okay, that's the way men say damn it. I don't recommend girls to use it because it's not appropriate. Now let's see how girls say that. Let's keep watching. He told his wife what happened. Let's hear what she said.
怎么了你？让人给碰瓷了。啊？你不是有行车记录仪吗？没用这玩意儿，演的可他妈像。Yes,
that's a softer edition of damn it. Let's hear it again. Yes, she said, 我去. Literally means I go, but it has nothing to do with go. It's just a softer way to say damn it. And here I'm going to give you a little map to show you how it was made and how to use it. Okay guys, that's all. And now comes a little promo. I know that learning Chinese sometimes could be frustrating. Sometimes it comes a moment that you want to give up. So I put some Chinese calligraphy art in my Esty shop with words like this, never give up or self-discipline. Hopefully it will remind you to never give up on Chinese study or in anything that in your life. I put the link down below for you to visit. So that's all for today. Please tell me anything you like or you don't like about my videos to make it better and more useful for you guys. So thanks for watching and for supporting me. I will see you next time. 再见!